What is going on, everyone? Nostalgia925 coming at you with yet another Explaining Digimon episode. In this particular video, we are going to take a look at a certain Digimon that many asked for, and I copy-pasted what I think are most of the names asking for it. You have Kanchomerox 12, Green Ukami, Zipzap, and all of you guys that have been writing. Thank you, a very big thank you for showing so much curiosity and love towards Digimon, considering that the franchise has so much potential and yet I have this feeling that it isn't treated the way it really should. Now, in this particular Explaining Digimon episode, we are going to be talking about the Digimon known as Betamon. We're going to study what the Digimon is all about, while also trying to reply to the many comments and questions I received in the Nostalgia925 community page concerning this particular Digimon. So let us get right into it. I have to say that I was quite surprised at how little there is written about Betamon. Luckily, there were many of you guys who wrote really, really interesting comments and questions in the Nostalgia925 community page. Trust me, at the moment we will reply to all these questions, you will come to understand that there is way more to Betamon than meets the eye. And because there is so little that is written about it, I will do my very best to stretch out the Digimon as much as possible. So that's why I think that it's better that I warn you that this video is probably going to take a long time, so maybe take something to eat, maybe take a drink, and let me start with the basics. You see, Betamon is actually an amphibian Digimon. Amphibian because it can live both on land and underwater, which also explains why it belongs to the Deep Savers family. Members of this field are generally aquatic Digimon or those who dwell in marine areas. It also belongs to the Nature Spirits family. Members of this field are generic animal or monster-like Digimon, or those who dwell in desert-like areas, which probably explains why it developed such sharp fangs and teeth. These tools can only raise the chances of surviving an encounter. And to finish, Betamon also belongs to the Dragon's Roar family. Members of this field are generally draconic Digimon, or usually descendants of the dragon Digimon known as Dracomon, the progenitor of all Dramon-type Digimon. And when we are going to take a look at the next forms of Betamon, you will come to understand how much impact the Dragon's Roar genes has on Betamon. I did notice that in the Nostalgia925 community page there were a lot of questions about the design of Betamon. So I took all of these questions and I will try and give my opinion on them right now. Might Dino wrote the following. I believe that Betamon is based on a fish that has developed limbs for land-based living but lived near water. Now I think that this analysis certainly sounds plausible, especially when we consider the well-developed limbs, which are high probably developed in such a way to make it easier for self-protection, or eventually to get those little creatures that might be hidden in certain spots like under the ground or inside a tree. Whitewing wrote the following. Betamon is certainly an amphibian type Digimon, most likely a salamander since their gills can be external, just like that orange thing in Betamon's head. Well, I can certainly understand why one might think that it would be a salamander. These animals are also amphibians and there are some similarities when it comes to the anatomy. From my point of view, I always believed that Betamon was a frog with claws and sharp teeth. However, those believing that Betamon is either a fish or a salamander or even a frog were all wrong. Betamon is based on the Dimetrodon grandis. And the Dimetrodon is often mistaken for a dinosaur, while it isn't one. In fact, it became extinct some 40 million years before the first appearance of dinosaurs. They are reptile-like in appearance and physiology, and are nevertheless more closely related to mammals than to modern reptiles, even though it is not a direct ancestor of mammals. You see, the gig on Betamon's body, while some may believe that it is hair, kind of like a mohawk as several said in the Nostalgia925 community page, if the Betamon design remained faithful towards the creature that inspired its creation, meaning the Dimetrodon, that gig would actually be bones. Sherita Matthews wrote the following. I like to imagine that gigantic fin is like a radar it uses for sensing danger, yet I will still hug it. Well, I have two things to add, one about the gigantic fin and about the hug. First of all, considering that Betamon is derived from the Dimetrodon, this would mean that they should more or less have the same characteristics. And while scientists aren't sure yet, there are a few theories concerning the sail that is formed by elongated neural spines projecting from the vertebrae. You see, the sail of a Dimetrodon may have been used to stabilize its spine or to heat and cool its body as a form of thermoregulation. And thermoregulation is the ability of an organism to keep its body temperature within certain boundaries, even when the surrounding temperature is very different. Some believe that the sale might have been used in courtship display with methods such as threatening rivals or showing off to potential mates. So the gig in Betamon might maybe be used to appear as a threat, and it might also be used to attract a mate. And specifically for Betamon, the gig can also be used for self-defense in case the enemy does not feel threatened by its first attempt of scaring away the rivals. And about the hugs part, I would say that you have to be careful for several reasons actually. Betamon can generate more than 1 megavolt of electric current to strike the opponent, and 1 megavolt is enormous, especially when you consider this quote. There are transmission lines that operate at hundreds of thousands of volts, though they are very carefully designed and constructed to be well isolated. And those lines, of course, can deliver enough current that solid contact with one, while grounded, would be instantly fatal. And Betamon can actually go way above these transmission lines, which only shows the potential fatal wound for those that took the Digimon lightly. Without forgetting that the gig on its back could also either seriously harm or potentially fatally wound a human being. So looks can be very deceiving, and that cute appearance Betamon has can easily be used to let someone's guard down. And unfortunately for those falling for that trap, people might actually really pay with their health or even life. Wyoming Hyundai Wei wrote the following in the Nostalgia 925 community page. Is Betamon the second Digimon created? When taking into account that the Betamon design is based on the Dimetrodon Grandis, a creature that was there before the reptiles, it is actually quite normal to ask yourself whether Betamon could in fact be among the first or maybe the second Digimon created. However, when we talk about the first Digimon or second Digimon that were created, we should actually take into account the ancient Digimon that were already there in a previous time. No doubt a period harboring many different Digimon, as we have mentioned some already, and more are about to come. Some of those Digimon have already gone extinct, like Ornismon, a Digimon that was discussed in the Explaining Biomon video. It is an ancient Digimon that already went extinct in the distant past. So to reply to the question, I doubt that Betamon is among the first or second Digimon created. I actually believe that the term Beta in Betamon is what might have given Wyoming Hyundai Wei the idea that Betamon might have been the second Digimon created. And speaking of Beta, here is a comment of TBC1 that wrote the following. Betamon, the true rival to Alphamon. A simple but very interesting comment. Betamon's name is actually based on the second Greek letter known as Beta. However, there are other Digimon that also have a name based on other Greek letters. For the first Greek letter Alpha, you have the Digimon known as Alphamon, a member of the Royal Knights, and the Digimon that we discussed in the Dorugamon video. For the Greek letter Delta, you have a Digimon known as Deltamon, a composition Digimon that was fused from 3 Digimon. I would highly recommend to the newcomers to subscribe. There are actually many theories concerning those 2 skull heads of Deltamon. Their identity are still covered in mysteries, but I will certainly dedicate an entire video about all the theories concerning those heads and discuss them. It is certainly going to be very interesting. To finish, for the last Greek letter Omega, you have a Digimon known as Omnimon, otherwise known as Omegamon. Another very powerful member of the Royal Knights, and actually the one member that I compared its technique, known as the Omega Enforce, to Goku's Ultra Instinct. It was a hypothetical battle. You can always see this video by clicking on the link in the description box, or by using the Digimon playlist where you can find all the videos. Now, I personally cannot say what the functions of those letters Alpha, Beta, Delta, and Omega would be when it comes to Alphamon, Betamon, Deltamon, and Omegamon. However, I believe that the answers can only be found by digging, which is what we're going to do. Who knows? It might maybe link these Digimon. Funtime Shadow Greninja wrote the following in the Nostalgia 925 community page. I am pretty sure Betamon has a variant called Modoki Betamon that can go down the Airdramon route. Well, Modoki Betamon is indeed a variant of Betamon. The Modoki means pseudo, hence pseudo Betamon. I can understand why one might imagine that the Airdramon could be a possible digivolution of the Digimon. Airdramon does look quite similar to Seedramon, which is the first champion form of Betamon that we will discuss in a second. As far as the research told me, Modoki Betamon cannot really digivolve further. But then again, Digimon are full of surprises. You are always free to write in the comment section down below what you might know about Modoki Betamon. The champion form of Betamon is called Seedramon, a sea animal Digimon with a long serpentine body which it can use to wreathe itself around enemies that are coming to attack. It can use it to constrict until the enemy suffocates. However, Seedramon does have way too many tools at its disposal to take down foes. It can, for example, spew absolute zero breath from its mouth, instantly freezing water that it fires at the opponent, which is actually quite impressive. The scary part about a Digimon is that it doesn't have intelligence or speech. It swims around the net ocean, leisurely, according to its instinct. So you won't be able to reason with it. Encountering a Seedramon can really be seen as bad luck, as you'd only see it in these places harboring large bodies of water, without forgetting that the Digimon is already huge. So to take it down, it will require a lot of expertise and luck. And the worst is that we're only talking about the champion form. Eliander Valderon wrote the following question in the Nostalgia Not 5 community page. I never understood Betamon myself or how it became Seedramon in its natural evolution line. White Wing gave an interesting answer to it. About Betamon's evolution line, it clearly shows a comeback to the seas since amphibians are the base for all reptiles, birds and mammals. Looking at Seedramon, we can see remnants of anterior and posterior members in the form of fins and its serpentine figure, possibly telling us that it evolved from an ancient reptile Digimon that returned to the sea. It is a good answer. Betamon is an amphibian Digimon, so it would only make sense that, through the process of evolution, it would have to find a habitat in which it has most chances of surviving and developing. In this case, we can assume that Betamon much preferred the sea to a point that it lost all meaning to remain on land, which is why Seedramon doesn't even have claws anymore. They were simply useless and thus disappeared through time. Manuel Trout wrote the following in the Nostalgia Not 5 community page. I have always been fascinated by the cryptid sea serpent. Seedramon is indeed a sea serpent or a sea dragon, as would be told in the various mythologies through time. In Greek mythology, Seedramon would be seen as a hydra. I will make sure to explore these inspirations that created Seedramon in the Explaining Mythology series. And in case you guys are new, it is a sub-Digimon series in which we take a look at those mythological creatures that inspired the design of certain Digimon. Seedramon, by some, could also be seen as the terrible Leviathan. I can surely understand that, but in the Digimon world, it is best not to link Seedramon to the Leviathan, as there is a Digimon that is part of the Seven Demon Lords that is named Leviamon, a Digimon that is derived from the Leviathan. While Seedramon on its own is already a very terrifying Digimon, its ultimate form, Mega Seedramon, is way worse. It is a Digimon that lived long in the harsh environment surrounding the Folder continent, a place that we will certainly explore in future videos. Mega Seedramon came into existence for the sole purpose to survive in the digital world, where the weak are simply food for those stronger. While Mega Seedramon in anatomy still looks kind of the same as Seedramon, aside of its red color, its body became a size larger and the carapace covering its head got harder. Remember how Betamon showed claws? I told you that it high probably lost these tools as it ended up evolving into a Seedramon to live in the ocean. Well, Seedramon did not have claws or horns, but Mega Seedramon developed a lightning shaped blade that grew on its calvaria, which is nothing more than a skullcap. It somehow reminds me of the gig on the back of Betamon. The gig, according to my assumption, is nothing more than bone, and the blade on Mega Seedramon's calvaria is part of that bone structure. So it is actually quite impressive how certain features of Betamon were lost once it digivolved into a Seedramon, and suddenly, due to harsh environment, it reappeared but stronger than before. Also, we do know that Betamon can use electricity. Its champion form, Seedramon, seemingly lost that ability, but Mega Seedramon can do it once more by using the blade of its calvaria. On the contrary to Seedramon that only moves based on its primitive instincts, Mega Seedramon developed a certain intelligence, so it chases its opponent persistently, sort of like a seeking torpedo, which is also why it can reliably bring down its opponents. There is, however, another variant of Mega Seedramon, one that is called Waru Seedramon, with the Waru referring to evil. If Mega Seedramon is a Digimon to be really terrified of, then what about Waru Seedramon? Let me tell you that this Digimon evolved in wickedness, and its personality has become even more sly. Its tenacity in chasing its prey exceeds that of Mega Seedramon, and with the horn on its head, it is able to control the powers of darkness. it can engulf its enemy in a whirlpool produced with the powers of darkness, which is actually quite impressive. To finish the line, Megacedramon has a mega form known as Metal Cedramon, an android Digimon. It is the final form of the Cedramon species and is covered in the strongest metal, Chron Digizoid alloy. And there is a lot that can be said about this alloy, but we will have to do it in another video. However, I can say that Chron Digizoid alloy is an intermediate material between Chron Digizoid metal and living tissue. That is why the metal is able to integrate with living tissue, like it did with Metal Cedramon. The advantage is that the Chron Digizoid alloy possesses both the super hard firmness of Chron Digizoid as well as the smoothness of living tissue. It works like an armor that will deflect any attack, which is actually the case with Metal Cedramon's body. Its metal body can reflect every attack, or to be careful with my words, you would need exceptional attacks in order to truly harm the Digimon. Furthermore, Metal Cedramon has the fastest speed of movement among aquatic Digimon, which is truly nuts as this Digimon has not only an immense speed, but also energy cannons that it can fire from its snout. So Metal Cedramon is as dangerous, if not more dangerous, than a submarine. Metal Cedramon was normally remodeled as a Digimon for use in interception under the sea, but through this process it was also completed as a Digimon for use in land and sea interception, sort of like the amphibian Betamon. Metal Cedramon was also remodeled for sky interception, meaning that almost every Digimon, if not all Digimon, are in danger when stumbling upon this Digimon. Blazing Arcanine wrote the following in the Nostalgia Not 5 community page. Betamon is the rookie form of one of the four Dark Masters. Indeed. Metal Cedramon is part of the Dark Masters, a group of four notorious mega level Digimon in Digimon Season 1. They were created by Apocalimon and had armies and certain locations in the digital world. I will certainly discuss this group in a separate video as they did have a lot of potential and deserve to at least be considered. I did tell you that Metal Cedramon was a remodeled Digimon. In the game Digimon World 2, there is a tamer known as Crimson. He is the leader of a group known as the Blood Knights. In the game, Crimson merged with a group of Digimon that were altered in their Chaos form. Among those that fused, you had Chaos Black War Greymon, which is a variant of War Greymon, but in greys and silvers. You also had Chaos Piedmon, which is a recolored version of Piedmon, yet another member of the Dark Masters group of Digimon Season 1. You also had Chaos Lord, a Digimon that looks like a recolored version of Machinramon, a Digimon that we actually already explained in the Explaining Machinramon Digivolution Line video. And the last Digimon that was used was a Chaos Metal Cedramon, a variant of Metal Cedramon that is mostly black and white. It has more or less the same characteristics as a regular Metal Cedramon, but it does have some extras. It has an attack called Brown Stinger. It is a technique of a Digimon called Flymon. So the attack poisons the enemy. The four Digimon that were mentioned were brought together and fused along with Crimson to form a Digimon known as Neo Crimson, an experimental life form. Some might maybe claim that the Digimon is not canon, but you have to know that the term canon doesn't really apply to the Digimon digital world, because in the end, it is a world that is connected to the internet, and the internet keeps on expanding, so it is hard to keep track of. In appearance, Neo Crimson inherits the feet and cannons from Chaos Lord, it has the tail of Chaos Metal Cedramon, and the two red floating ribbons on its back are from Chaos Piedmon. It wields Chaos Black War Greymon's Drummond Destroyer on its right arm, and also wears the Brave Shield on its back. Certainly a very interesting Digimon, I would love to take a look at its story by analyzing the game, but this will actually depend on the feedback I receive and the requests. In the Explaining Gomamon video, I discussed one of its mega forms known as Plesiomon, a dragon Digimon. Along with Metal Cedramon, they can both fuse together in order to form Aegis Drummon, a cyborg Digimon. If you want me to name a Digimon that is perfect for heavy assault, then Aegis Drummon would high probably be the best candidate. It has a pair of cannons on its arms, it has guns on each side of its back. It also has many wing-like appendages allowing for both flight and great swimming capacities. Without forgetting that it also has that cyan horn-like Mega Cedramon, which might maybe give it the ability to use lightning, but that really wouldn't matter when it comes to Aegis Drummon, especially when you consider its arsenal. The term Aegis in Aegis Drummond derives from Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System, a program developed to provide missile defense against short to intermediate range ballistic missiles. In order to defeat Aegis Drummond, you would need way more than just luck or darkness or huge firepower. This Digimon is well prepared or is even designed for combat in sea or in the air, meaning also on the ground, so everywhere. Aegis Drummond can completely annihilate the target with the gigantic explosion of super destructive energy produced from the fusion of the two types of energy at the point of convergence of all the bombardments. The explosion releases a glistening golden flash which gives off the feeling of terrifying power and divinity at the same time. Aegis Drummond is definitely a Digimon we need to consider in those versus battles and probably also in those videos that are made to provide a top list of the most powerful characters, or in our case, the most powerful Digimon. To finish this already long video, there is still the Betamon X line we need to discuss. In case you are new on this channel, the X in Betamon X is a reference to the X antibody, a vaccine that makes the Digimon immune to the X program, a termination program that eliminates 98% of the Digimon population. I have yet to talk about this story in detail, but we will get there. Betamon X changed in appearance in comparison to Betamon. It looks a bit more sharper, I would say. It can further digivolve to Cedramon X, Mega Cedramon X, all of them have the same capabilities, maybe a little bit stronger, maybe not. But more importantly, Giga Cedramon, the last Digimon we are going to discuss in this video, but you really need to pay attention. It is an android Digimon and a carrier of the X antibody. It is also a successful elaboration on Metal Cedramon, as it is able to demonstrate an even faster speed of movement and a stronger ability for interception under the sea. Giga Cedramon is a Digimon that was constructed in absolute secrecy by the Crack Team, an army of Digimon all created by the works of a team of hackers with unknown purposes. We will of course dig deeper in order to find out what this group wants, as they are also involved in a story with a god member of the Olympus 12 known as Bacchusmon, and there is a certain plan to create biological weapons, and this god might be the key to the creation of those weapons, but this will be discussed in another video. Giga Cedramon was constructed in extreme secrecy by the Crack Team in order to expand its sphere of influence. It is endowed with the ability to control the sea and give the team of hackers the possession of a cruising range which covers the vast net ocean. I would say that the Crack Team has a serious advantage over the other teams that were mentioned before, like the Bansho Team, the D Brigade, or even the Seven Demon Lords or the Royal Knights, as the Crack Team are working in complete secrecy. So most people aren't even aware that they are there. Despite the secrecy, they are already in a possession of serious tools that can easily shift the balance of power. Giga Cedramon's length exceeds that of Waymon, and Waymon's enormity is of the highest class in the digital world. It is so huge that the volume of data it carries can't even be processed by a normal computer. But I will also explore the height of this Digimon in another specific video, because it is actually quite difficult to get a proper number. But see it like this, because Giga Cedramon is so huge, and because it is a member of the Crack Team, it can even load a Digimon such as Chaos Dromon in its interior. Chaos Dromon is a Digimon that we already discussed in the Machindermon video. So Giga Cedramon is no longer this lone Digimon. It is possible to say that it is an assault landing ship for which it isn't known when and where it will appear on the net ocean or when it will launch an attack. This is the end of the video, my good friends. I really hope you didn't mind that it took that long. I myself am quite surprised that there is so much to Betamon than was written in those different sources. And Betamon also pointed the Digimon Conversation series in a certain new direction, considering all these little hints we got, which is only lovely. Oh guys, I remember I did compare Cedramon to the Pokemon Gyarados. People wrote many interesting stuff, so maybe you should take a look at it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the Nostalgia 95 channel. I will dedicate many videos to Digimon, to the mythological creatures that inspired certain Digimon, and I'm going to make sure to help the Digimon community or the Digimon franchise to expand and to grow, because, well, this series was my childhood after all, so it really deserves more attention. So I hope you guys will be with us Don't forget to post comments, as, well, you've witnessed, I also use all of your comments to create these videos. That way I can say that we work together as a team, as a community. In case you guys are new, you can always go to the Digimon Conversation playlist or the Mythological Conversation playlists. They are always updated. That way you can catch up on newer and older videos.